This is the Bahamas Tonight, the National Report. I'm Keishla Adderley. Thanks so much for joining us tonight. Topping the news, a Haitian embassy official has issued a counterproposal to the government's deadline for shantytowns to be cleared. The official has asked that residents be allowed to lease or buy the properties where they've lived for years, insisting that they haven't had time to prepare and are wary of losing their investments. Here's Betty Thompson-Moss.
The week ahead could bring new possibilities for those residents in shanty towns across New Providence. While the deadline to vacate the premises is just weeks away, the residents are hoping to present the government with a new proposal.
They are willing to rebuild the shanty town with their own possibilities, and they will respect all the requirements. Allow the electricity, waters, everything, and give another face to the shanty town, and allow the government, Damien, to have a happy ending, and them to live in a better place.
First Assistant Secretary at the Haitian Embassy, Carl Henry Chatelier, has been working closely with the Bahamas government, local pastors, and others from the Haitian community. He says leasing the land is another option being considered.
They want to purchase, or if the governor want to lease them to, if they can have an accord, if they can have something that can allow them to stay on the land, and there's something legally, okay, and they can pay every month, and they will rebuild the shanty town.
The Haitian official revealed that residents have also been presented with a unity option that would allow 4 to 5 families to reside together to create a better environment.
They know their situation is not good. Yes. And they know their condition is unsanitary. They don't want to stay in that condition.
But if the options fail, the Haitian representative feels more time will be needed to allow residents to relocate.
After August 10, I don't think so they will be ready. Because there's a lot of families, they were quiet since June and the beginning of July because they know the house was safe. But since last week, The storm has begun for them.
And the decision to extend the deadline, purchase or lease the land in shanty towns, will be placed in the hands of the government. Betty Thompson-Moss, ZNS Network News.